last few weeks have been difficult ones for Jerry Coverson.
The minute I heard about Pastor Paul's resignation, my heart broke for him. My need right away at that time was to be able to share my heart, to share in the grieving process.
And Jerry knew exactly where she could go. To a house in San Bruno, where on most Friday nights, a group of former strangers forged a family. A growth group that has met here for the past 3 years. Sam Pilley is the growth group leader.
You know, each one of us had different issues, financial, marital, a whole bunch of issues that we've all faced individually in our group that we have combined together to pray over. With Pastor Paul's resignation, it was, I don't think anything greater than anything we've faced, but it just hit everybody at the same time.
Including Jesse Marquez, who has been part of the growth group since it began. Like Jerry, Jesse knew where he could receive encouragement as well as offer it.
As I go up those stairs, I'm safe. It has been so difficult through the weeks, but I know once I make it on a Friday to Sam's house, I'm safe. And it's funny because we all feel the same way.
It's a group that has shared many experiences over the years, studying the Bible, traveling together on missions trips, supporting a charity for orphans, and connecting throughout the week by phone and by text with prayer requests.
We know if a text message is coming in, you need to stop whatever you're doing, and we pray for each other on the spot. We are truly a family.
I think belonging to a family really gives you a foundation where when things go bad, you kind of just come back to that foundation and you find that you can talk about it, you can get advice about it, get a different perspective on it, so not to focus directly on it, but pan out and see the bigger picture. Our focus is on the Lord, and He is who we have to build our life on. And so that's, I feel very confident that God will keep us.
And He's confident that this group will continue to be a blessing to one another and to others.
At my growth group, I find just an outpouring of God's love. I feel that our growth group would be with me for any crisis that would come about in my life.
When I look around the living room, I see a group of people that want to love Jesus, want to be more of what God wants them to be. People who are hungering to be like Christ, people who want to draw closer to Him, don't want to live a normal, standard life. They want to be used by God.
Praise God, it was blessings everywhere.
Nothing from this world or from the enemy could topple the growth group, the church, the body of believers. It's not possible at all. We serve again a sovereign, mighty God. The only thing that it can do is bring us closer to Him.
Closer to Him and closer to each other.
Wherever God is doing something, I want to be a part of it. And that's what I see with the rest of our growth group. God is doing something in our growth group, God is doing something in our church, and we want to be a part of it.